Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my self-randomizing color combination lock, which you can see right in front of you. This build is heavily based on my previous simple and compact color combination lock, with some additional circuitry at the back of it. And I designed this to work around one major issue all color combination locks have, or all combination locks in general have, and that is, if you're entering the code, and someone is watching you doing so, this someone will also have the code and will be able to enter your base. So to work around that, I figured out this self-randomizing color combination lock. And well, let's show this in action. So at the moment, the current combination is pink, yellow, pink. And as you can see, if I enter it, you will see this thing here opening up. But if I now unsolve it, you will see the circuitry here at the back starting shuffling around and changing the current combination into a completely new and entirely random one. So no trespasser can easily enter your base from that point on by simply watching you enter the current code. And that's basically what this thing here does. Now let's talk about the sizes. So it's a modular design. Each module is 3 blocks wide, 8 blocks high, and 9 blocks long, although you may need a few blocks at the front to hide away some of the circuitry. And with that, let's get to the required resources. So the resources for one normal module without the randomizer I already talked about in the previous tutorial, so here just a quick few. But for the randomizer, you're gonna need additionally some components, which are, of course, building blocks, then 2 slabs, 8 redstone dust, 3 redstone torches, 3 repeaters, 2 comparators, 2 observers and 2 sticky pistons, 2 droppers and hoppers, and finally 2 node blocks. And additionally, you're gonna need at least 1 non-stackable item. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's show you how to build this combination lock here. Okay, so the first step is building one module of my simple and compact color combination lock I showed you in an earlier tutorial. And here, to be more precise, you need the version that has 10 blocks inside of this loop. Once you've built one module, it's time to go to the back of it and first remove those 2 redstone wire here. Then place a block up here and down there. Remove those 2 blocks. Put a repeater on 1 tick in this direction. Then next to it, a temporary block like so. Now we can place our dropper here and the hopper where before we had a full block running into the dropper. Put down 2 redstone dust like so. Then inside of the hopper you can already place 3 items. Next we need to go and take an output towards the back from the dropper with a comparator. Run this into a full block with a torch on top of it. Block on top. Torch to this side. Then we need 2 lowered blocks like so, redstone dust here and a repeater on 4 ticks in this direction. Then grab your slabs, place one upside down next to this dropper here, put redstone dust on top and a torch on the side of this block. Then we need one upside down on top of this redstone wire there. Next place 2 raised blocks here with redstone dust on top of this slab there. Running into a full block with a dropper next to it and a hopper running into it like so. Then put a stackable and a non-stackable item in there. Now we need to take an output from the hopper towards the front of a comparator. Run this into a full block with a lowered block around the corner and one further down there. Put redstone dust on top of both. Grab your node block, place it inside of this gap here. Then let's go on the opposite side. Place a node block in front of this observer there. Then you may want to place a block on top of it to make it silent. Put a block here. Redstone dust on top. Block on top. Then next to this block here, we need a sticky piston facing downwards, and then we should have enough space for an observer powering this block below. Then we need another block, full block on top of here. followed by another sticky piston in this direction. Replace this block here with an observer in this direction, then running the full block and finally take an output of a repeater on one tick. And that should be one module built. Now let's give it a little test run. First, let's solve that module here. Now the items from this hopper should be in the dropper in front of it. And if we unsolve it, now this system here should start to cycle through. And that's what you want to see. The next step is, of course, copying this module a few more times. And voila, so now I have three modules in total. I also added a little entrance that is controlled by those modules here. And if I now solve the entire thing, you will see the entrance opening up. And if I unsolve it, you'll see that the entire thing here starts to randomize, as you can see. And now the system is safe once more. And with that, we have finally reached the end of this tutorial about this self-randomizing color combination look. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya! Oh, and by the way, if you haven't noticed the date this thing here was published, just know that this was primarily meant as a little April Fool's joke. Although you might consider using this in some kind of, well, adventure map or something similar, if you want to annoy your players.